be here in Vietnam, in the very heart of the Indo-Pacific, to address the people and business leaders of this region. This has already been a remarkable week for the United States in this wonderful part of the world. Starting from Hawaii, Melania and I traveled to Japan, South Korea, and China, and now to Vietnam to be here with all of you today. Before we begin, I want to address all those affected by Typhoon Debray. Americans are praying for you and for your recovery in the months ahead. Our hearts are united with the Vietnamese people suffering in the aftermath of this terrible storm. This trip comes at an exciting time for America. A new optimism has swept all across our country. Economic growth has reached 3.2% and going higher. Unemployment is at its lowest level in 17 years. The stock market is at an all-time high. And the whole world is lifted by America's renewal. Everywhere I've traveled on this journey, I've had the pleasure of sharing the good news from America. But even more, I've had the honor of sharing our vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific, a place where sovereign and independent nations with diverse cultures and many different dreams could prosper side by side and thrive in freedom and in peace. I am so thrilled to be here today at Apec, because this organization was founded to help achieve that very purpose. America stands as a proud member of the community of nations who make a home on the Pacific. We have been an active partner in this region since we first won independence ourselves. In 1784, the first American ship sailed to China from the newly independent United States. It went loaded with goods to sell in Asia, and it came back full of porcelain and tea. Our first president, George Washington himself, owned a set of tableware from that ship. In 1804, Thomas Jefferson sent the explorers Lewis and Clark on an expedition to our Pacific coast. They were the first of the millions of Americans who ventured west to live out America's manifest destiny across our vast continent. In 1817, our Congress approved the first full-time Pacific development of an American warship. That initial naval presence soon grew into a squadron, then a fleet, to guarantee freedom of navigation for the growing number of ships, braving the high seas to reach markets in the Philippines, Singapore, and in India. In 1818, we began our relationship with the Kingdom of Thailand. And 15 years later, our two countries signed a treaty of friendship and commerce, our first with an Asian nation. In the next century, when imperialist powers threatened this region, the United States pushed back at great cost